Morning students, today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter number 2, that is exponent. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the meaning of exponents. So to understand the meaning of exponent, observe the following multiplication. If I multiply 2 itself 4 times, then I get the answer 16. Now, another expansion, if 3 multiply itself 5 times, then we get the answer 243. Friends, what do you observe from this example? From these examples, we observe that we can write this, we observe that if a number multiply 4 times itself, we get the answer 16. Can we write this multiplication in a different way? Yes, we can write this multiplication in different way. That way is this one. If I write this way, and this one is 3. So how to read this one? So here we will read 2 to the power 4 is 16. 3 to the power 5 is 243. So students, here I written 2 its power 4. So 2 is here base for us, that is called base, and 4 is its power. So we can use here the word power, otherwise exponents, and another name is index. Out of this 3 name we can use any one, but the most popular that we are using, that is power. So here we read 2 its power 4 equals to 16, otherwise we can say 2 raised to the power 4 is 16. If the students, the power of any base is 2 or 3. So whenever the power of any base is 2, here we use a particular word to read this power, that is square. And here we read 2 square. And if the 3 is there, we use cube. So we can read 2 square and 2 cube. So this way we can read the power, and that is called the exponent. I repeat again, if a number multiply itself in time, so that is called that number of time, how many that time it multiply, that is called its power. So here 2 multiply itself 4 times, so here 2 power 4. 3 multiply here itself 5 times, so here it called 3's power 5. Now after this, friends, we are going to discuss some rules that related to the exponent, and on the behalf of these rules we are going to solve the exponents. So these rules are, first, according to the first rule, if base repeat many times in form of multiplication, if the same base multiply itself, in that case always power add. That means we add the power. How? Here A repeat 5 times and A power is 1 only. So we can say A power, A is base is here common, and power 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 1 2 3 4 5. So we can write A power 5. So this rule we can say, if any two number, for example A and A, but their power is different, here is power 2 and here is power 3, multiply together, then in that case always power add. So we can say if the base are same and we multiply them, then always power plus. So here the power become 2 plus 3 a power 5. Second rule, if the base are same and in case of division, if the base are same in case of division, always power subtract. So here the power will be a 3 minus 2, then power is 1 and we are not writing power 1. This is the first rule. When the base same and we multiply, power add. Rule number second, if the base same and we divide, then power subtract. Now the third rule, if any base whose power is 0, that value is 1. That means the full base equal to 1. A 0, that means 1. B 0 equals to 1. So if any variable whose power is 0, that equivalent to 1. Now then rule number third, if power are same and base are different. How? For example, A power 5 multiply B power 5. Base are different and power are same. In that case, first we take the product of base, yani A multiply with B, we write directly AB and we write their power as a common. Means A power 5 multiply B's power 5, and if we write together AB whole power 5. So when we solve this one, A power 5 and B's power 5. This is the fourth rule. Now according to the fifth rule, if any rational number is given, if any rational number is given and they have given their power common, PQ, its power is 3. So when we open the bracket, this power is numerator also and as well as denominator also. So this power said to be a common power and it is the power of P also and Q also. In another case, if we take the reciprocal of number, for example, according to the sixth rule, if any number is given, for example P and Q, its power is 3. When we take the reciprocal of this number Q upon P, then also its power will remain 3, and when we open it, that Q power 3 and P power 3. But here some one condition is that, friends, that when we take the reciprocal of any number, that's numerator not equals to 0. Why? That we know very well. If then, because when we take the numerator, its reciprocal numerator convert in denominator, and if the denominator is 0, that is infinite, invalid term, and there is no solution of that term. So that's why we can't take any denominator as 0. Now there's another rule, rule number 7. If any base whose power is given and then after it enclosed with the bracket and outside the bracket they have given another number. So students, in board marks we have discussed, when we remove the bracket and there is no sign between the bracket, that number always multiply. So when we open here the bracket, here we take the product of these two numbers, 5 2's are 10, so a power 10. I repeat again, students, if any base bounded in bracket and outside the bracket they have given any whole power, that power multiply with inside power given. So here the a power is 5 and whole power is 2. So when we open this bracket, solve this bracket, 5 multiply with 2 and a power 10. 5 2 is 10, so a power 10. Now the one another rule that we are going to discuss, if any negative number, if any negative number is there and its power is positive, if any negative number is there and its power is a positive number, sorry, its power is an even number, then we get the answer positive. If any negative number whose power is even number, we get the answer positive. If any number whose power is odd number, then we get the answer negative. This thing you have to remember, students, when you solve the questions, you solve the integers. If any number whose power is even number, that's mean we get the answer positive. If any negative number whose power odd number, then we get the answer negative. Okay, students. Now, then after we are going to discuss some questions from exercise, that is exercise number 2.1. In exercise 2.1, first of all, express the exponential notation. Means they have given us a number. Exponential notation means we have to convert this number according to their power. For example, first they have given to us 32 and we have to write 32 in exponential notation. Students, here we follow the method of prime factorization. By prime factorization, first of all we find out the factor of this number. So to find the factor of 32, 2 1 2, 2 6 12, 2 8 16, 2 4 8, 2 2 4 and 2 1 2. Now the all the factors of 32 is 2 multiply itself 5 times. 2 multiply itself 5 times. So how we can write this one? We can write the 2 power 5. Now we have written this number in exponential notation. Okay, friends. If the number is given in the form of the fraction also, then also we follow the same. They have given in the third part of this question. Minus 343 and 512. Now, friends, first we have to make the factor of 343. 343, if I make the factor, that is 7 7 and 7, that means 7 multiply 3 times. Students, here one thing we have to remember, if we are going to express any rational number in exponential notation, so the power will remain same for the numerator and denominator. Means the numerator and denominator having the both same power. So here 512, we make only that factor only easily, which can convert in 3 only. So we have to find like that number only. So how to find 512? So we can start from the smaller number, 2 2 is 4, 2 5 is 10, 2 6 is 12. 2 1 is 2, 2 2 is 4, 2 8 is 16. 2 6 is 12, 2 4 is 8. 2 3 is 6, 2 2 is 4. Then after same 16, 8, 4, 2 and 2. Here we observe that 2 repeat how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If 9 divide in 3 equal parts, so we can take 3, 3, 3. So here, 1 pair of this, then second pair, and 3, third pair. So 2, 2 ja 4, 4, 2 ja 8. 2, 2 ja 4, 4, 2 ja 8. 2, 2 ja 4, 4, 2 ja 8. So here we can write 512 as a factor of 3 times 8. And if we convert in exponential notation, we can write minus 7 by 8 whole power 3. Why? Because minus 7 is power 3 and 8 is power 3. And we can take it's a whole power, minus 7 by 8 whole power 3. Understood, students? So on the behalf of this, you have to solve the question given in exercise 2.1. Thank you, students.